Now, moving on, basic transformations, is it clear what happens when you replace x with x minus h? What happens when you replace x with x plus h? Everything is clear? Just to quickly recap, in any function, if you replace your x with x plus h, where h is some positive quantity, the graph is going to shift h units to the left.
Yeah.
Right? Let me just take this example. Let me take this function y. Okay. So let's say y is equal to, I'll take another function, fx is equal to, I'll take a same function, same type of function, x square minus 5x, let's say plus 4. Yeah. This is my function. Okay. All of you can see the function now. Now in this function, I'm going to plot another function by replacing my x in the function of h with x plus 2. Do you see the red graph? What has happened? It has got shifted 2 units to the left. Correct?
Yes, sir.
In the same way, if I replace my x with x minus 2, you would realize that the graph will now shift 2 units to the right direction. Correct? In a similar way, if you replace your y with, if you replace your y with y plus k, your graph is going to move up by k units if k is positive. Okay. And if you replace your y with y minus k, the graph is going to go down by k units. Yes or no?
Sir.
Let me show you that. In the same function, I'm now going to plot. Yeah. So y is equal to x square minus 5x plus 4. Okay. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to change my y with y plus 2. See the graph going, will it go up or go down? Y plus 2 means the graph is going to go down. Yes or no? As you can see, it has gone down. Okay, if you replace your y with y plus k, the graph is going to go down. And if you are going to replace your y with y minus k, the graph is going to go up. Okay, so as you can see, the graph has gone down. Now the same equation, now I'm going to change y with y minus 2. See the graph going up. Is that fine? So now we are going to continue with the session that we have over here. So this concept is understood by all of you, that when do we get a positive answer? And if you follow upper minus lower and integrate from a lower value of x to a higher value of x, you will always get a positive answer. Is that clear? Now, there are some area that you can actually calculate by considering horizontal strips. In the previous case, I talked about vertical strips. Now, there are some area which you can find only by taking horizontal strips. Let's say I want to find the area given by this figure. Okay. And let me tell you, these are two curves, x equal to f of y and x equal to g of y. Another important thing here is that we need to write the equation of the curves as x equal to f of y and x equal to g of y in this case. Unlike the previous case, our equation was written as y equal to f of x and y equal to g of x, right? So here you have to make x the subject of the formula. I'll tell you why it is required. So let us say you are integrating the area, or you are finding the area sandwiched between these two functions. Okay. Between y equal to a till y equal to b. So what you are going to do next is you are going to take at a distance of y a thin horizontal strip like this. So you are going to take this strip. Yes or no? Thickness is dy. Correct? Now if I ask you, what is the height of the strip? Height of the strip will be dy, no doubt about it. Correct? What is the width of the strip? What is this distance? You would say it is nothing but the difference of the x coordinates at these two points. So it is nothing but x2 minus x1. Correct? And if you look deeply, what is x2? X2 is nothing but fy. So x2 is nothing but fy. X1 is nothing but gy. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So the difference in this is going to give you the width of the strip, and which if you multiply with the height is going to give you the differential area dA. Right? And now I'm going to integrate this from y equal to a till y equal to b. And remember, if you want your answer to be a positive one, if you want this answer to come out to be a positive one, ensure that this is positive and this is positive. Now, can somebody tell me how do you ensure that fy minus gy is positive? Any guesses? How do you ensure fy minus gy is positive? Fy should always be the curve which should lie on the right or left?
Right. Right.
Exactly. It should lie on the right. And gy should be the curve which should lie on the left. Because right minus left means you are doing a higher value of x minus a lower value of x. Remember, as we go right on the x axis, we start getting positive values or increasing values of x. And as we go to the left of the x axis, we get decreasing value of x. So right minus left will always be positive. So if you do right minus left and integrate from a lower value to a higher value, you will always get a positive answer. You would never need a mod and all. Is that clear? So guys, in order to know whether my curve is on the right or left, we again have to be very, very good with our graphs. If graphs is not good, this chapter is not meant for you. Correct? So graph and the transformations which I have discussed so far are the biggest prerequisite, along with some understanding of functions, in order to excel in this chapter. Are you getting this point? Now, the first question that arises in our mind is, when we are solving the graph, when you're solving the question of area under curves, what is the first thing that we should do? So let me point out the first thing. First, always plot the graph as accurately as possible. Plot the graph as accurately as possible. This is the first step that you should do. Okay. Second step is, Second step is decide whether you have to choose vertical strips to integrate or horizontal strips to integrate. Or you could use both. This is the biggest call which you should take, whether I can integrate the area by just using vertical strips or just using horizontal strips, or would I need both? That means, how would my integration process be less if I break the area into strips? Let me give you a very simple case to understand point number two. Let us say I have a circle. Okay. Let's say the circle is y is equal to f of x equation. And I have a parabola. The parabola is, let's say y is equal to, same color, y is equal to g of x. Okay. And I want to find out this area. I want to find out this area. Okay. Now, what kind of strips would be suitable to find out this area? Any guesses?
Horizontal.
Horizontal would be the most suitable one. Why? For very simple reason is, if you make a horizontal strip like this, let me choose some other color. If you take a horizontal strip like this, you are only going to use the curve on the right, which is going to be your, now here the equation is not given to you in the form of x equal to f of y. So first you need to convert this as x in x equal to some, let's say h of y. And this also you have to convert x equal to some k of y. So this area could be easily found out if you could know the y coordinate of this point, let's say a. So you can integrate it, or you can find the area easily by doing the x on the rightmost function, which is your h of y, minus k of y, that is your curve on the left of the function, left of the strip. That means where does this lie and this lie? So this lies on this and this lies on this, correct? So the difference of the x coordinate from 0 to a, this would simply give you the answer in straight away, one shot. However, if somebody wants to solve the same question by taking vertical strips, let me tell you what challenges the person will face. Let's say, first of all, he has to find this point, which is A, this point, which is B. Okay. And he would require to choose two definitions of the strip. One like this and another one like this. Correct. He would need two definitions of the strips. One is this fellow and another is this fellow. Yes or no? So can you tell me what expression should he write, assuming that the circle is y is equal to f of x and the parabola is y is equal to g of x? He would write something like this. Integral from 0 to a. Now where is the tip? Where is the upper end of the strip? G of x. Correct. Where is the lower end of the strip? At y equal to 0. Plus integral from a to b. Now, where is the upper end of this strip? On the circle. Yes or no? Circle is f of x minus 0. So unnecessarily, you'll have to take two integrals to solve this problem. Whereas in this case, you could have solved this question in just one integral. Correct? So guys, you have to be very, very judicious in taking a call. whether you need a vertical strip or a horizontal strip or a combination of both in order to get your area. Are you getting this point? And dosto, and finally, the last step is you would have to be very, very careful in integration. Right? Though the integrations involved will not be of very high level, because we are dealing with some standard functions like circle, ellipse, parabola, hyperbola. No, we'll be dealing with straight lines, we'll be dealing with modulus function, we'll be dealing with GIF. So you have to be very, very careful in performing the integration. If these three steps are taken care of, then you'll find this chapter super easy. Okay.